Regularly scanning your code is essential for maintaining its hygiene, just like taking a shower that keeps you clean. When scanning, it's important to look for common patterns, such as passwords or API keys that could be exploited. Additionally, it's important to scan for any hard-coded credentials. Gitleaks does all of that for you. Let's see how we can use it, keep using it regularly using some kind of CI, and applying deep fixes to long-forgotten sensitive data that was committed to the Git tree. Installing Gitleaks is as easy as brew install Gitleaks on a Mac. See the README for other operating systems instructions. In the help menu, we can see that there are a few options. The two most important ones are Protect, that helps with fixing issues when they arise, and Detect, which we'll mainly focus in this video. Let's run Gitleaks Detect just to quickly see what a clean repo looks like. Without any additional instructions, the tool scans by default the entire Git history and reports any findings, which in this case do not exist. Here's a repository where the owner never bothered with scanning. There are 22 different findings, which is quite concerning. Using the verbose flag, you can see access tokens, AWS credentials, Slack credentials, etc. I'll stop here because it gets actually worse, and we really want to avoid exposing the developers involved. Gitleaks can also export the data into a JSON report, where we can see here a private key together with the line it appears in, the name of the file, the actual secret that it found together with the developer, the email, the date it was committed, etc. Let's see an example of integrating secret scans into your CI. To start, I'm going to open the Gitleaks toml, which is a configuration file that lets you add rules that make sense in the context of your application. You can add a scan rule or tweak the existing ones. For example, if there's a type of credential that's unique to your application and Gitleaks isn't aware of, that's the place to add it. I like to keep security and regulation steps in their own files like this one. I'm using the official Gitleaks image here, and there are a few important things to note. One, I hard-coded a version to prevent my process from breaking when a new version is released with breaking changes. This actually happened last year. Additionally, here the developer failed the step and still had the pipeline succeed with the allow failure true. So take this as a bad example of handling things. You shouldn't be able to pass any pipeline if a security check fails. Also, you can see that the scan only covers the last 4 days. This is bad practice on the developer's part. Just for fun, let's scan the code base without this limitation to see what's there. There's 614 findings. No wonder someone didn't want it in the logs. I'm not going to go into each and every finding here, as it's going to be too much, but you get the idea. Let's see how you can remove secrets from the Git tree, even ones that have been committed early on and are nested deep into the history. The BFG Cleaner is a tool used to delete large files and sensitive data from Git repositories. It is faster and more efficient than conventional methods, making it ideal for removing large files and credentials from the entire history of a repo. To use it, all you have to do is run the BFG command with the desired options and parameters. You can delete files, provide a pattern to match file names, remove blobs based on size, replace text by injecting a replacement, or even delete entire directories. I'm installing BFG with Homebrew because I'm on a Mac, but any package manager will do. Run the tool just to see we're good to go, and let's go ahead and test its functionality. I'm going to create an ID underscore RSA, which stands for a private key file name, something we most definitely don't want committed into our Git tree. I'll add the file and commit it and check that I can see it in the logs. I can even verify that using Telescope in NeoVim to see that the contents are there. The easy solution to such a mistake is to git reset head 1, which tells Git to remove the last commit. By the way, with dash dash soft flag, I can make sure the files stay in my workspace. But we're going for BFG, so let's use the tool to delete the ID RSA file. The output is interesting. BFG tells me that it found the dirty file, but that's now linked to my head, which is protected. If I were to push a commit that deletes the file and then run the tool again, it'll do its work. So with that in mind, let's do this, but let's do it for real. I'm picking a repo that I know has lots of issues in its history, 116 of them to be exact. Remember this number as we'll circle back to it and check again after applying a fix. I can see that the file by the name config.prod.json comes up a lot, and that's probably wise to delete. With BFG running, I can see one commit that's still protected, but other than that, there are almost 10,000 commits that require cleaning. There's a nice visual line showing the history of commits and when dirty commits were introduced, as well as a modified commit after which the file was deleted. From the head, obviously, rather than the history like it should have. When BFG is done, it suggests we run reflog expire. The expire subcommand prunes older reflog entries. Entries older than expire time are removed from the reflog. Then, with git gc, we clean up unnecessary files. Git gc, as introduced by the docs, is like a house cleaning for the repository. When that's all done, BFG can run again to find only 26 issues. Remember the number earlier, 116? That's a huge improvement. Repeating this process is as simple as you can see and will contribute a ton to your code health and the general hygiene of the application, and by extension, your team, your company, etc. As you can see, security is very close to my heart, and if you want to see more on this, feel free to leave a comment below. See you next time.